Hello, good afternoon. Could you please introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about the political process coming towards World Water Day today and your ideas about how we move forward from today?
Yes. Hello, everyone. I'm Federico Properzi, and I work in UN Water. I'm the Chief Technical Advisor, and UN Water is the interagency coordination, United Nations interagency coordination mechanism for all freshwater-related matters. So UN Water is actually playing a big role for the organization of the World Water Day campaigns. And for this year, it's a very important year for us because it's the theme of World Water Day is water cooperation, which is actually enshrined in a General Assembly resolution, which declared the whole 2013 as the International Year of Water Cooperation. Now, what's even more interesting is that this year actually happens while we are looking at the 2015 and what could the post-2015 development agenda be. So what happened before this World Water Day is that there was a global thematic consultation on water, which was mainly online, but also through social media and also through meetings around the world, which collected people's views on what is the role of water in the post-2015 development agenda. And so this global thematic consultation culminated here today on World Water Day, and culminated in an outcome statement of the high-level forum that we just had here in The Hague, and which says very important things, because it says the high-level forum, we actually welcome very much the messages which are coming from the people, which basically say, yes, water is important for sustainable development, which was already something, which we know, but also the RioPlus20 outcome document was saying. So now we have given officially this statement to the president of Liberia, Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, to bring to Bali next week, where the high-level panel of eminent persons for post-2015 development agenda is meeting. It's one of the meetings to discuss this. And as you know, the high-level panel will produce a report by end of May, which will inform the work of the General Assembly in September. So between now and September is a very important moment, because this is where all the information from member states to decide on the roadmap towards 2015 and beyond will be put together. There is also a member states process which is called the Open Working Group, and negotiations will take place in New York. So the outcome of this day really fits into this global movement towards 2015 and beyond. It feeds into the high-level panel process, it will feed into the open working group process, and all these things will converge in September at the General Assembly, and we'll see where we go from there with the roadmap to 2015 and beyond.
Thank you so much for sharing this.